Hey guys, TGCast Productions. In this video, I'm going to be explaining how to play and win the most recent free mode event that has been added to Red Dead Online, Wildlife Photographer. Now, I've played this free mode event personally two times. First time I played it, I actually got second place. The second time I played it, I got first place. I'm not 100% guaranteeing that you're going to win with this video, but I can definitely for sure increase your chances and success with this free mode event with the tips that I'm going to be discussing in this video regarding Wildlife Photographer. So this free mode event was added this past Tuesday, August 18th. I guess you could say it's part of the drip feed of the Naturalist role update or part of the extending content of this DLC. And it doesn't appear you earn Naturalist role XP from this free mode event as you do with the other two Naturalist role free mode events, the wild animal tagging free mode event, as well as the protecting legendary animal free mode event. Those two you actually earn Naturalist role XP for. It does not appear though that you earn Naturalist role XP for this mode, but you will still earn cash and XP. And also what's, I guess, sort of another incentive to complete this mode is it looks like, I'm assuming at least this week, if you complete any free mode event, including Wildlife Photographer, you will earn a benefit for $100 cash in Red Dead Online, as well as 5,000 character XP. So a little bit more of an incentive to give this new free mode event a try. And one more thing I'll state really quickly before we get into the actual mode. I'm not exactly sure of all the times this free mode event spawns. Personally, for me, I've played the past 2 days around the same exact time, which is around 12, 1 a.m. Eastern United States time. It was actually just one of the random free mode events that could occur. So that was the time I played it. Likely at some point, someone will update a list with all the times that this mode will spawn. But those are the times, at least the time that I have played this mode, or at least the two times that I've played it. So when you load into this event here, and I apologize for the quality when I recorded this, but you'll see some notifications that says you're pretty much competing with other players to take pictures of animals and pretty much the quality of the picture, including the animal species, the composition, and the proximity, all is going to affect the amount of points that you earn for each of these pictures. And that's pretty much, you know, I'll be talking about all that in this video. Now, getting into the mode, I'm assuming when you start this mode, even if you don't own the advanced camera, it likely will give it to you, just like in the wild animal tagging freedom event. If you don't have sedative ammo or varmint rifle, it will give it to you temporarily. But I will assure you that the advanced camera is definitely the way to go with this. Even if you can use the other camera, you're not going to want to do that. So you saw me coming up to this dog here. And before that, I saw this dog actually on the minimap. Highly recommend you need to keep a close eye on the minimap, because you're going to see white, I guess, illuminating or radiating dots on the map, and that is going to indicate there's an animal there, and you're going to want to get over there as quick as possible, especially if it's close to you, to try to get the pictures, because obviously, like I said, that's the most sure way to know there's an animal that you can take a picture of and score points with. The other thing you also may have noticed there is I put my camera away. Highly recommend that you do not run with the advanced camera, because that is something that you can do. You have a little bit more maneuverability with the advanced camera. Makes it a lot better for photographing wildlife, but you're not going to want to have that out when you're running, because you cannot activate Eagle Eye. And you're going to want to be activating Eagle Eye, because as you can see here, there's actually a white-tailed deer track that I found that I can use to track down the white-tailed deer, photograph it, but also just using Eagle Eye in general will highlight wildlife animals, and it'll make it a little bit easier for me to find them. So definitely, once, like I said, if you're not photographing an animal, I would recommend just putting your camera back in your inventory and then just using it once you're actually ready to photograph an animal, because you want to utilize Eagle Eye. Something else I recommend for this mode, if you have them, you can either buy them from Harriet, or if you have the pamphlet unlocked, which can also be bought from Harriet, you can craft these. But those are the blending tonics. It does appear that you can get closer with the blending tonics. I do believe they work in the Wildlife Photographer free mode event like they do in Free Roam. It would make sense that they do. It should allow you to get closer to the animal, and therefore, obviously, getting, I guess, a proximity bonus, or, you know, earning more points because you're getting a closer photograph of the animal. Something else I will mention, this sort of goes back to what one of the notifications say at the beginning of the mode. You'll see here that this picture of this white-tailed deer that I took, it was a fairly clear picture. I was fairly close to the animal. I ended up getting 13 points, or scored 13 points for taking a picture of that animal. However, up here, I found a raccoon And I ended up taking a picture very similar to the picture I took with the white-tailed deer around safe proximity. Fairly clear picture, and I actually earned 31 points. So it does appear that obviously, you know, taking different species, as it stated earlier in the mode, may score you more points. However, obviously, don't just be skipping over animals trying to find a certain species. Any animal you come across, you're going to want to photograph because, again, you're going to want to earn as many points as you can because there may be, you know, a period of time where you don't come across any animals. So you're going to want to photograph any animal that you can or you're going to find, but it does appear that different species are going to obviously give you more points. Another tip that I can give you is you only want to take 3 pictures of the same animal. And you might have noticed this previously when I was taking a picture of the raccoon that only took 3 pictures. But you can see here with this horse, I only take 3 pictures as well. And the reason why is you're only going to gain, I would say, a good amount of points or an increased amount of points with the 3 pictures. In fact, after you take 3 pictures, you're only going to, for each picture after the 3rd picture, the same animal, you're only going to score 1 point. Therefore, it is definitely not worth photographing the same animal. So I would only photograph the same animal 3 times, and that's it. Usually your last picture will maybe earn you around like 5 to 7 points, and that is it. I would not take any more than 3 pictures of the same animal. That's all you want to do. At that point, you're pretty much going to want to move on and find another animal after taking the 3 pictures. And one last thing I want to mention here before I review everything. This was the second time that I played this mode. It's actually the time that I won it. It does appear that there are predatory animals you can come across. Actually, looks like I came across a grizzly bear here. Definitely do not recommend getting that close to it, even if you have a blending tonic, because if it works like free mode, as soon as the animal becomes an enemy and it appears as a red dot on your minimap, you, at least in free mode, you can no longer take a picture of it. And I'm assuming that they may be able to attack you in this mode, which means you could likely die and may be canceled out. I don't know if you have infinite lives. I'm not sure if you can possibly die, but that is something I'd recommend. Don't get super close to the predatory animals because, you know, there is a possibility that you may die there or, you know, in the long run, risk losing the event. One more thing I should probably mention before the review. As you can see here, there's a stat for best photo, and you can actually see the 3rd placement here got the best photo. 43 points, Mohican Chief. That was his name, or the player's name. Getting the best photo, apparently, according to Rockstar, there's a bonus for getting the best photo in the event. I personally don't know what that is. Both events that I played, I did not get the best photo. However, I scored very high. Like I said, I got 1st place in this one, 2nd place in the other one. Just because you get the best photo doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to win the event. I personally don't know how to necessarily get the best photo. Someone may end up coming up with that, but I can assure you, at least at this point, getting the best photo doesn't mean you're going to win the entire event. Like I said, both times I didn't get the best photo and I still scored 1st, 2nd place. So, you know, yeah, you may get a little bit of a bonus. Like I said, I don't know what that is for getting the best photo, but it doesn't necessarily mean you're going to win the entire event. Now, finally, what I want to do in this video is review everything that we discussed regarding how to play and win the newest free mode event, Threaded Online, Wildlife Photographer. So the first thing that I mentioned in the video was keep a close eye, or what you're going to want to do is keep a close eye on the mini map for those, I guess, alerting dots or white dots that you'll see. And obviously you see these in free mode too as well, when there's like a treasure hunter nearby, some sort of event that is occurring, like a campsite, same type of alerting dots or white dots that are on these mini maps. You're going to want to keep an eye on them because that's pretty much going to indicate that there's an animal nearby for sure. I mean, obviously you can find an animal outside of those white dots, but it's going to for sure guarantee there's an animal there that you can hurry up and go over and photograph and earn some points from. The second thing that I mentioned, or a tip that I gave, was when you're not photographing an animal, make sure you put your camera back in your inventory, or you just ensure you don't have it out when you're running, because that'll disable you from being able to use Eagle Eye. You want to be using Eagle Eye because obviously you're going to be able to better find the animals and also track them down as well. So when you're not using the camera to photograph animals, put it back in your inventory. That way you will be able to use Eagle Eye. A third tip I gave in this video was using blending tonics, which once again can be bought from Harriet, or if you have unlocked the pamphlet, you can also buy the pamphlet from her and craft these. It does appear the blending tonics work in this free mode event, although I haven't in-depthly tested them. it did appear that I was able to get much closer to the animals. I also don't know for how long these last. I tried to do some research on it. I couldn't find anything. So if you're watching this, you know how long blending tonics specifically last for. Definitely, I'd appreciate if you leave a comment down in the, you know, in the video to say how long these last for. That way, players can better time on when to keep applying another one during this event. A fourth tip that I gave was ensure that you only take 3 pictures of the same animal. Again, if you take more than 3 pictures of the same animal, you're only going to earn 1 point for each of those pictures after the third one taken. So definitely ensure that you do not take more than 3 pictures of the same animal. I would say the fifth and main final tip that I gave in this video is if you come across a predatory animal in one of these events, I just wouldn't recommend getting that close to it. Again, I'm not sure if you can die in these modes or this particular free mode event, wildlife photographer, but you may get more points for getting closer to it. I mean, definitely want to get closer to it, but don't get to maybe as close as you would to some of the other animals, because like I said, it may attack you, it may kill you, and you may end up losing the mode or losing the free mode event overall. So I wouldn't get quite as close to the predatory animals as you would to all the other animals. And also with the best photo taken, of course, again, according to Rockstar, there is some sort of bonus you get for getting the best photo out of the players in the free mode event. However, that doesn't necessarily mean you're going to win the free mode event, at least from my experience. Like I said, in both events, did not have the best photo, and I still managed to score very high. Again, first place in the last one that I, or the second time that I played, and second place the first time I played. So scoring the best photo, from my experience, doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to win the overall event. It really comes from overall taking decent pictures in high quantity. In any case, guys, that's pretty much everything I wanted to discuss regarding how to play and win the Wildlife Photographer free mode event. I will say this mode is also great for trying to complete the animal field guide or trying to progress through that as far as photographing animals and tracking them, because you are able to do that in this mode, this free mode event. So if you're trying to progress through the animal field guide as far as photographing animals and tracking them, this event can also help you do that as well. But in any case, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it beneficial. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, share this video. Be sure to comment if you have any questions. And as always, have a great day.